નમસ્તે, હું આદર્શ છું. વેલકમ ટુ આદર્શ એજ્યુકેશન સોસાયટી.
હેલો સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ, ટુડે વી આર ગોઈંગ ટુ લર્ન સ્ટાન્ડર્ડ 6, સબ્જેક્ટ ઇંગ્લિશ ગ્રામર, લેસન નંબર 3, નાઉન્સ જેન્ડર. એઝ યુ નો સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ, ઇન અવર પ્રીવિયસ લેસન, લેસન નંબર 4, વી સ્ટડીડ અબાઉટ નાઉન્સ સિંગ્યુલર પ્લુરલ. નાઉ ટુડે ઇન ધીસ લેસન વી હેવ ટુ સ્ટડી નાઉન્સ જેન્ડર. બિફોર સ્ટાર્ટિંગ અવર એક્સપ્લેનેશન, જસ્ટ વી હેવ ટુ રિવાઇઝ વોટ ઇઝ એ નાઉન. જસ્ટ કીપ અટેન્શન હિયર. નાઉન્સ ઇઝ એ વર્ડ વિચ રિપીટ પર્સન નેમ, પ્લેસ નેમ ઓર થિંગ્સ નેમ. ઇટ ઇઝ નોન એઝ એ નાઉન. વી સ્ટડીડ અબાઉટ અવર ઇન અવર પ્રીવિયસ લેસન. નાઉ ટુડે we have to divide nouns according to gender in this lesson. So let's start our lesson. First of all, here nouns are divided into 4 categories according to the gender. Nouns are divided into how many categories? 4 categories according to gender. According to gender, noun is divided into 4 categories. Which type of 4 categories? Now we have to see it. First one is that masculine gender. Masculine gender means what? Masculine gender indicates the male form of the species. Masculine gender indicates the male form of the species. Male form. If male is there in noun, it is known as a masculine gender. If male, related to male word is given, that is considered as a masculine gender. Now second one is that feminine gender. Feminine gender indicates the female form of the species. It indicates the female form of the species. If nouns or depict the female, related to female word is given, we can say that it's a feminine gender. Related to female word is given, then it's a become a feminine gender. Can you understand two types? Now third type is that common gender. Third type is that common gender. Common gender means what? Indicates either a male or a female form of the species. Either a male or a female. It is not decided. It is a male or female. At that time, if living thing is there, at that time we have to use as a common gender. Example we can see downside. Okay? Common gender. Living things but not decided. It is a male or female. So we can use it as a common gender here. Now next step is that neuter gender. Neuter gender indicates neither a male nor a female. Means non-living things. All the non-living things came inside that gender, neuter gender. Non-living things, for example table, chair, it is all came in that type of gender, neuter gender. Can you understand, student? Now, 4 types of gender. Now, I draw a chart here to understand our nouns based on gender. Here, 4 types of gender is given here. First one is masculine gender. Masculine gender, example, man. Man word is related to male. So, it has become a masculine gender. Like that, second word is given as example, father. Father word is also related to male. So it's a book known as a masculine gender. Can you understand, student? Now second one is a feminine gender. Here example woman is written. Woman word is related to female. So we can say that woman word is a feminine gender. Like that mother word is given here. Mother noun is given. Mother is also related to female form. So we can say that mother is a here, feminine gender. Now third one is that common gender. Common gender example, first one is that doctor. Doctor noun is given here. It is not decided male doctor or female doctor. Only we can say that doctor. If we know the doctor, he or she, हमें पता होना चाहिए कि डॉक्टर मेल है या फीमेल है. अगर हमें पता नहीं है तो इट इज नॉन एज ए कॉमन जेंडर. इट इज नॉन एज ए कॉमन जेंडर. सेकंड एग्जांपल टीचर. ए स्कूल यू कॉल्ड ऑल द टीचर एज ए टीचर. इफ टीचर इज मेल और फीमेल, वी कैन से दैट ओनली टीचर. सो हियर टीचर बिकम कॉमन जेंडर. टीचर बिकम कॉमन जेंडर बिकॉज it is not clarified that it is he is a male or a female. So we can say that like that types of noun came under common gender, doctor, teacher, advocate, like that. But living thing must be. Last one is that neuter gender. Neuter gender example table is given here. Non living things we can put here on neuter gender type. Non living things, table, chair, fan, board, all the things can in a neuter gender. Now students, understand about four major types of gender in our English grammar. Nouns have four types of gender. Keep in mind, masculine related to male, feminine related to women, related to female, common gender related to both, either male or female, but a living thing must be there. So it's known as a common gender. And last one is that neuter gender. It is related to non-living things. It can be a table, chair, for example. Understand students about all the things? Students, next topic. Here, I read from here, just keep attention here. Some professional nouns are used similarly for both males as well as females. They are identified by pronouns or other contextual words in the sentence. As you know, student, in our previous PS screen, we studied about common gender. So it's a one type of common gender. Explanation is given here. If some professional nouns use the similar for both males as well as females, we can see that, for example, doctor. Doctor may be male or may be female. So it's not a clarified here in that common types of gender. They are identified by pronouns or other contextual word in the sentence. How we can identify that is a male doctor or female doctor? We have to see the other pronouns, sentence pronouns and other contextual words. If in sentence pronoun he is used, we can say that it's a male doctor. If pronoun is she is used, then we can say that here female doctors we are talking. So we have to see the sentence other contextual word and pronouns to identify which type of common gender it has. Can you understand, student, here? Now next topic is that some nouns are made feminine by adding a prefix or a suffix to them. Some nouns in our English grammar we can form as a feminine by adding prefix and suffixes. Prefix means we have to add a single word or a single letter, single or more than single letters from a beginning side of a word. It is known as a prefix. And we can add after the word new words, we can add two or more words or single words and any characters on a after word is known as a suffix. Prefix means before word, suffix means after word. Can you understand? We can form them by adding prefix and suffixes. For example, here boyfriend is given here. Here, before friend, boy is added. So it's a non-adjective prefix here. Boy is a non-adjective prefix here. We can convert it into feminine gender, like that girlfriend. Friend remains same, but we have to change here gender. So it will become a girlfriend. Now next example is there a landlord. Here land is a common word. After land we have to add lord word. It's known as a suffix. Landlord. So here we have to change the gender. Land remains same and lady we have to add. So it will become a feminine gender. Can you understand? So then here now next and last topic of our lesson is that besides these there are many nouns that are neither masculine nor feminine. They represent neutral gender. As we see in our previous screen that neutral genders definition. Here neutral genders topic is come. See here. Besides this, there are many nouns that are neither masculine nor feminine. So it's a non-living things. We can say that it's a neutral gender. They are mostly used for non-living objects or proper nouns. They are mostly used for non-living objects, non-living things and proper nouns. Proper nouns means our personal noun, name. It's a known as a proper noun. Uncountable nouns and abstract nouns are also represent a neutral gender. Uncountable nouns, that nouns we cannot count it. That type of noun is known as a uncountable nouns and abstract nouns also represent neutral gender. For example, here given chair is a non-living thing. We can say that it's a neutral gender. Bravery is one type of abstract noun. It is one type of abstract noun. We can say that it's a neutral gender. Cloth we cannot count. It's a one type of uncountable noun. Uncountable noun also came under the neutral gender. Then plant also known as a neutral gender. Understand student about nouns gender now. Here our lessons teaching part over. We have to do exercise in our next screen.
Students, in the previous screen we discussed teaching points related to nouns gender. Now we have to do exercise based on that our teaching points. But before starting our exercise, just we revise it. Nouns gender. There are mainly four types of nouns. Students, we studied about nouns gender. First one is their masculine gender. Indicates the male form of the species. Example, father is given here. It's related to male. It's known as a masculine gender. Feminine gender. Feminine gender indicates the female form of the species. Example, mother is given here. Feminine gender is related to female word. Common gender. Common gender indicates either a male or a female form of the species. Example, doctor. It is not decided it is male or female. That type of noun is known as a common gender. And last one is the neutral gender. Indicates neither a male nor a female. Non-living things form as known as a neutral gender. Example, chair is given here. Now based on that our study, we have to do exercise A. Exercise A is given here. Identify the nouns in the given sentences and say whether they are masculine or feminine or neutral or common. We have to decide which type of noun is there. We have to find out the noun first of all, and then we have to decide which type of noun's gender is there. First sentence is given here. My cousin's birthday is next Saturday. My cousin's birthday is next Saturday. Here, which is noun? Can you understand? Yes, cousin is a noun here. Cousins is a noun here. It's a common gender. Cousin means maybe. It may be male or female. Cousin means living things here. So it's a living thing, male or female. So cousin become here common gender. So you have to write answer like that. First of all, you have to write word cousin, then dash common gender. Can you understand, student? How to write? So here first sentence over. Second sentence is there. The milkman of our colony supplies bread as well as eggs. The milkman of our colony. First of all, we have to find out the nouns from that sentence. Here milkman is a noun. Milkman. Milkman. Which type of gender can you decide it? Yes, milkman is a masculine. It is related to male. So we can write that milkman, masculine gender. Second noun is given here also, bread. Bread is a second noun. So you have to write bread. Bread, which type of noun? Non-living things is given here. Bread is considered as a neuter gender. It is known as a neutral gender or a neuter gender. Can you understand? So milkman become here masculine gender and bread become here neutral gender. Understand? Now next sentence we have to understand. Third sentence. The inspector was sure that there are illegal goods in his bag. The inspector, here inspector is a noun. So inspector, inspector may be male or female, or it's a living thing. So we can say that inspector become here common gender. It's become a common gender here. Second noun is given here bag. Second noun is given here bag. So bag is a non-living things. We can say that it's a neutral gender. Understand student? Inspector, common gender. Bag, neutral gender here. Now fourth sentence. How far is Beijing from the capital of Japan? How far is Beijing from the capital of Japan? Here Beijing is a noun. Beijing is a noun. It's a not non-living things. So we can say that Beijing is a neutral gender. Second noun is given here, Japan. Japan is also non-living things. We can say that it's a neutral gender. Both Beijing and Japan is neutral genders. Sorry, Beijing and Japan's are neutral genders. Can you understand, student, now? Now, fifth sentence we have to understand. Fifth sentence is given here. You should show gratefulness for whatever you have received. You should show gratefulness for whatever you have received. So here, which is noun? Gratefulness is noun here. Gratefulness is a abstract noun. It is an abstract noun. So abstract noun always known as a neuter gender. So gratefulness become here neutral gender. Can you understand, student? Next, sixth number. The tigress came nearer to her cubs and gave another snarl. The tigress, here tigress is a noun. It is related to female. So we can say that tigress became here feminine gender. Second one is there, cubs. Cubs also noun here. Cubs may be male or female. So we can say that cubs here is a common gender. Understand, student? Tigress feminine gender and cubs here common gender. Next sentence, sentence number 7. Sentence number 7th we have to do. The woodcutter saw a beautiful fairy emerging from the lake. The woodcutter saw a beautiful fairy emerging from the lake. Which is noun here? We have to find it. First of all, woodcutter is a noun here. So woodcutter, woodcutter word is related to male. So we can say that woodcutter is here masculine gender. Second noun is fairy. Second noun is there fairy. Fairy is related to female. So we can say that fairy is a feminine gender here. And third gender, lake is given here, third noun lake. Lake is non-living things, so it's become a neutral gender. So woodcutter is masculine gender, fairy is a feminine gender, and lake is a neutral gender here in that sentence. Now, 8th number. They were still confused as to who was to be the heiress to the throne. Which is noun here? Can you find out? So, heiress is a noun here. It's related to female. So, we can say that it's a feminine gender. And second one is there. Second noun is throne. Throne is a non-living things. We can say that it's a neutral gender. Understand? Heiress is a feminine gender. And throne is a neutral gender here. Next sentence, sentence number 9. We have to understand. Sentence number 9. Number 0 was introduced to the West through the Arab traders. Which is noun here? We have to find out. Here noun only traders. Traders is a noun here. Traders may be male or female. It's not clarified here. So traders become here common gender. Traders become here common gender. Now 10th number. Who is the author of Anne Frank's diary? Is a controversial question. Who is the author of Anne Frank's diary? Is a controversial question. Which is noun here? Author is a noun here. Author may be male or female. So we can say that author is a living thing. We can say that it's a common gender. Author become here common gender. And second word is there diary. Diary is non-living things. We can say that it's a neutral gender. Understand, student? So here our exercise A over. You have to complete exercise A in your grammar textbook with pencil. Answer key is given of exercise is. A is here. You have to write like that. Cousin, then desk, common gender. Second sentence, milkman, that masculine gender. Bread, neutral gender. So you have to complete all the 10 sentences in your grammar textbook. Understand, student? Thank you for joining us.